Welcome Shim Stars, welcome to the mathematics class. Today we will revise lesson 6, factors and multiples. Today we will understand factors and highest common factors.
See students, factor means factor of a number is a number which completely divides the number without leaving a remainder. That is, suppose I am taking the example of 8. Here 8, when I divide 8 by 1, answer is 8. Here remainder is 0. And when I divide 8 by 2, I get the quotient 4, and here also remainder is 0. When I divide 8 by 3, here the remainder is not 0, it is 2. Here I divide 8 by 4, here also the remainder is 0 and the quotient is 2. When I divide 8 by 5, here also remainder is not 0. When I divide 8 by 6, here also remainder is not 0, it is 2. Same way as with 7, here also remainder is not 0, it is 2. And when I divide 8 by 8, here the remainder is 0 and the quotient is 1. So in these 4 cases, that is 1, 2, 4 and 8, here the remainders are 0. So all these numbers, that is 1, 2, 4 and 8, these are the factors of 8. So numbers 1, 2, 4 and 8 divide 8 exactly, leaving no remainder. They are all factors of 8. So students, to find out factors, you will simply divide a number by any counting number. If there is no remainder, that is remainder is 0, then that counting number is a factor of the given number. Now to find out multiples, multiples clearly indicates multiply only. So you have to just multiply the given number with the counting numbers, you will get the multiples. Like here again I am taking the example of 8 only. First I am multiplying 8 by 1, then by 2, then by 3, 4 and so on. Here the answers that I get, that is 8, 16, 24, 32, all these numbers are the multiples of 8. Multiples can be infinite because you can multiply with any number. So multiples can be infinite, and multiples are always greater than or equal to number. Here you can see, here 16, 24, 32, all these numbers are greater than 8. Either 8 is equal to 8, so either the multiple can be equal to that number or greater than number. Multiple is never smaller than the given number. But factors are exactly opposite. Factors are always smaller than the number. They may be equal also. Here 8 is also a factor of 8. They may be equal or smaller, but they cannot be greater. Factors cannot be greater, and factors are limited because wherever you find remainder 0, that is only the factor. Otherwise it is not a factor. So factors are limited, and multiples are unlimited. Infinite number multiples you can have. Now students, I will tell you a simple method to find out the factors. This method is known as multiplication method, or you can call it as cup shape method also. Suppose we have to find out the factors of 28. So first of all, I'll start with 1. 1, 28's are 28. Now I'll go to 2. 2, 14's are 28. Now I'll go to 3. See students, 28 does not comes in the table of 3, or in the rough column you can divide and see. You will see the remainder is not 0. You are having some remainder here. See, the remainder is 1. It means this does not 3 is not divisible by 28. So you will leave 3. Now you will go to 4. 4 sevens are 28. Same ways, 5 is also not divisible by 28. 6 is also not divisible by 28. Now you will go to 7. 7 fours are 28. But we have already written here 4 sevens are 28. Now 7 fours are 28. 4 sevens are 28. The conditions has reversed. So you will stop here. Wherever the situation like this comes, it has repeated. It means you will stop there. No need to go further. Now you will make a cup shape here. That's why this method is known as cup shaped. You will make a cup shape like this. Now all these numbers are the factors of 28. That is 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. These are the factors of 28.
Now we will do HCF. HCF means highest common factor. Students, suppose you have to find out the HCF of 16 and 20. First of all, you will find out the factors of 16. Here the factors of 16 are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Then you will find out the factors of 20. Here the factors of 20 are 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. Now you will find out common factors. See, HCF means highest common factor. First of all, you will find out factors. Then you will find out common factors. Here the common factors are, see, you can see one is common in both. One is always common in because one is a factor of every number. So one will be always common. Now 2 is also common and 4 is also common. So here common factors are 1, 2 and 4. Here 1, 2 and 4 are the common factor. But we have to find out HCF, that is highest common factor. Now you will find out the highest amongst this. The highest amongst this is 4. So the highest common factor is 4. Now I'll tell you two more ways, methods to find out the HCF. One is the prime factorization method and another is the long division method. Here in the prime factorization method, first you will find out the prime factors of the number. Suppose you have to find out the HCF of 18 and 42. First of all, you have to find out the prime factors. See, prime factors means they should be factors also and they should be prime numbers also. Prime numbers, you know, first 5 prime numbers you have to by heart, that is 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. These are the first 5 prime numbers and you have to by heart these numbers. Now let us see how to find out the prime factors of a number. Suppose I am having the number 18. Always I will start with the 2 because 2 is the first prime number. So always I have to start with the 2. See, I will start with 2 here. 2 9s are 18. Now again this number is 9. Now I will check whether this number comes in the table of 2 or not. No, 9 is an odd number, so it does not come in the table of 2. So now if a number is not divisible by 2, then I will go to the second prime number, which is 3. So now I will go to 3. 3 3s are 9. So I will write 3 here and second 3 here. First of all, I will go to 2. 2 9s are 18. I will write 2 here and 9 here. Then 3 3s are 9. Now this is the prime number 3. Again, it is divisible by 3. So here 3 1s are 3. Now 1 has come here, so I will stop. I have to continue this process until 1 comes here. Now you can see all these numbers are prime numbers, that is 2, 3 and 3. These 3 numbers are prime numbers and they are factors also. So this is known as prime factorization. You can check your answer also. Like you can multiply these 3 numbers and see. 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18. So my answer is right. Same ways you will find out the prime factors of 42 also. Always you have to start with the 2 first. 2 21s are 42. You can, in the separate rough column, you can divide and see. Then 21 is an odd number, so it does not come to the table of 2. So I have to go to the number 3. 3 7s are 21. I'll divide 21 by 3. My answer is 7. I have to divide these two numbers and here I have to write the quotient. Now this is a prime number only. I told you first prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7 and 11. Prime numbers means it doesn't come in the table of any other number. So you will write 7 only here. 7 ones are 7. Now you have got the prime factors of 42 also. So that is 2 into 3 into 7. Now how you will find out the HCF? Just see. You will write the prime factors of 18 and you will write down the prime factors of 42. Then you will circle the common amongst them. See, 2 is common in both and 3 is also common in both. You will write the prime factors of 2, 2 into 3 into 3. You will write the prime factors of 42, 2 into 3 into 7. And you will circle the common factors in both. 2 into 3 is common in both. So common prime factors are 2 into 3, that is 6. So highest common factor is 6. HCF is 6. Now we will find out HCF by division method.
Students, the long division method is very useful when we need to find the HCF of large numbers. You can see here the numbers are large numbers. So here in this case, the division method is very useful. What you have to do is you have to simply divide two numbers. This bigger number you will write as a dividend and the smaller number you will write in the divisor. Now you will start dividing. 144 ones are 144. Here the remainder is 72. Now this 72 will become the new divisor. This 72 will become the new divisor. See, you will make the division sign again. This 72 will become the new divisor and this 144 will become the new dividend now. Now again you will divide. 72 twos are 144. Now the remainder is 0, so you will stop. Now the number 72, the last divisor is 72. This last divisor is the HCF of 2144 and 216. The HCF of 216 and 144 is 72. Now students, let us do one more question. Here I have to find out the HCF of 624 and 264. Here the numbers are large numbers, so I will choose the division method. So the bigger number will become the dividend and the smaller number will become the divisor. Now I will divide this. 264 into 2 is 528. Now the remainder is 96. Now this remainder, that is 96, will become the new divisor and this 264 will become the new dividend. Now I'll proceed with the division part. 96 twos are 192. Now I'll subtract. Here it is 72. Now this 72 will become the new divisor. Now this is the remainder, but now it will become new divisor and this 96 will become the new dividend. See students, you have to continue this process until the remainder 0 comes. So here 72 ones are 72. Here again you can see the remainder is 24. It is not 0. So you have to keep on continuing this. Now 24 will become the new divisor and 72 will become the new dividend. 24 threes are 72. Yes, see, now the remainder is 0. You can see this is the long process. My page is also completed. Okay. See, now the remainder is 0. It means HCF is 24. So the last divisor is the HCF. The last divisor is 24. Here this is the remainder is 0 and the last divisor is 24. So HCF of 264 and 624 and 264 is 24. Students, you will practice activity 3, question number 1, 2 and 3. At least 3 parts you have to practice. See, first question is find the common factors of the following and then find the HCF. Here you can practice the 3 parts like A, G and H. In the second question, again you have to find out the HCF by prime factorization method. Here also you can practice this A, G and H. Here for question number 3, find the HCF by long division method. Here also you will practice A, H and I part. 3 parts you have to practice. So you can practice A part, H part and I part. Thank you, Shemstars. That's all for the day. You can drop your queries on the Google Classroom.